I figured out a way to implement this change in only the index.html file. Remember, that's where the templates are stored. Now, I haven't used Backbone a ton, and there wasn't an answer waiting for me, so I had to figure it out myself. Let me go through my thought process. The first thing I noticed is when we check a box, something actually happens here. Where is the code that makes that happen, I asked myself. Well, I remembered that each one of these is rendered based off of a template, and that template is here in the HTML file. So I scrolled down and found it, and sure enough, right here is the input, the checkbox. And it says input class equals toggle, type equals checkbox, and then this weird thing. So what the heck is that? It turns out this is the way the template conditionally adds things. This here is interpreted logically. It's not just normal HTML. It's actually interpreted by Backbone. And it says completed ? Checked or empty. So if completed is true, then add the checked attribute. Otherwise add no attribute. Now what I wanted to do is I wanted to add a done text to the end of the title. So I figured this looks like the title right here. I could probably just do the same thing here, right here. So when completed is true, we wanna spit out checked. Let's save that and go into our browser and see what that looks like. If I hit refresh, you'll see that it says run the application checked. Explore the file structure checked. Modify our application, nothing's here. But if I click the check mark, sure enough, checked. Now that's not exactly what I wanted it to do. I want it instead to add the text --done. Let me save that and go and refresh. And sure enough, --done. So I tested it, it worked. And then I went back and I added an exclamation point because I was really excited. So that really was only a couple steps. First, I noticed that something changed when we checked the box, and that's what I wanted to change. I found the code that made that happen in the item template in our HTML. And I looked at the syntax that was making this happen, and I basically copied it. Changed it up a teeny bit, tested it, it worked, and then I added the exclamation mark. So that was pretty simple. And it's because I've done this before, not this problem, but I've gotten code that is not my code, and I've had to find a way to integrate my changes. And ultimately, it's the practice that helps. We aren't learning to solve individual problems anymore. We're ultimately learning how to be a detective. Well, a tofu detective, actually. One who can track down where the change should be made and then integrate seamlessly into the code that's already there.